Hey, it's Nick. Have you ever wanted to make a bobblehead that looked just like you? Well, today I'm going to try to do that. Let's get started. There's a couple ways to make a bobblehead that looks like you, but I think the easiest is going to be to scan myself. So I'm going to use my Creality Scan Otter and scan my head and body so that I can 3D print them at different sizes so I can make this bobblehead. The Creality Scan Otter comes in this nice little carrying case, and it comes with all the cables and stuff that you need. Here's the actual scanner. It plugs in with USB into your computer. Now I'm going to start scanning my face. I need to hold the device at a distance that it tells me is optimal. It'll show on the screen a little green bar where the ideal distance is, and then I can press start and it's scanning. Obviously you don't want to be talking while you're scanning, but this is just for demonstration purposes. Okay, I'm gonna do another scan now. That'll be the real scan. One thing I really like about the Creality software is that it will let you take multiple scans and then combine them together. You just need to make sure you have enough overlapping data that it has something to recognize. So I'm going to do that with my head and scan the back and the sides and combine it all together into one. Now I'm going to attach the scanner to a tripod mount so that I can scan my body. I have a turntable that I'm gonna stand on, and then I'm gonna scan multiple times and combine it all together. Okay, so now I got the top of my body. I'll do that a couple more times and combine them all together. Obviously, if you have someone to help you scan, it makes it a lot easier to do, and you could just do one pass. Once I finished all the scans and combined them into one piece, I brought them into Blender and cleaned up the base. I erased any little bits and added a cylinder so that the whole thing will be able to stand without falling over, because the head is going to be much bigger than the body. Finally, I printed it out. I originally tried to use my resin printer, but I was having serious trouble with it, so I ended up having to use my FDM printer. So I got these print lines, which is pretty annoying. But luckily, the head, I was able to use the resin printer, and it turned out quite well. So I cleaned it off. I sprayed both prints with a kind of off-white spray paint as a base color. And then I started painting the head. I mixed up some acrylic paint and did a flesh tone, and I covered the whole thing, and then I started adding more details, like darker areas around the eyes. This was a little too dark. I lightened it up a little bit, and then I painted in the hair and the eyebrows. And finally, the eyeballs. It looks so much more realistic once you get the eyeballs in there. So then I painted the body. It wasn't as smooth as I would have hoped, and I didn't have enough time to sand it. But luckily, I was wearing all black when I scanned myself, so black kind of hides some of the lines. And then finally, I added a spring to the tiny head, and I put the big head on top to make my bobblehead.
Well, thank you for watching. I hope you liked the video. And don't forget to go out and make something weird.